Well, here's our room on August 6, 1995. Here's where the skylight would be. Here's the main beam. Here's some of the wiring right here behind the TV set. Over the fireplace. Above the slider. I'm not sure what this wire is. Telephone, maybe. Maybe not. The vanity goes right here. Toilet over here. Shower stall. Fan light would be up here. Let's go to the vanity light. And AC outlet for the family room. Skylight. The bathroom light fixture. Shower stall fixtures. Exhaust for the shower stall. Exhaust for the toilet. Water for the toilet. No.
Huh?
No, it's okay. The light switches for the bathroom. That's most likely an outlet, AC outlet. And here's a double switch. Here's the attic. And there's, looks like the exhaust for the vanity. Right, straight up there. Here's some of the wiring to the new switch to the garage door from the kitchen. Here's the wiring for the patio light, and we'll have another one for the outside floodlights. All going right straight up here. Something's going up way up there also. Fireplace gas valve shut off. There's the AC outlet under the window next to the gas valve, obviously. And here's the wiring to there. Splits off. Goes way over there. The other side goes way over here. Okay, there's all the chicken wiring done, and the roof is all done. There's the fireplace. Waiting for stucco to be put on. It should be sometime next week. New hose bib. Here's all the gas stuff that was done from Doug yesterday. Doug Anderson. Here's the side of the house, the new part. Here's under the deck by the fireplace. Inside the fireplace.
Little kid in a big wheel over there. Look over there. Yeah. Hey, Amanda. Hey, Don. Hey. Oh, Amanda. Is he right here? surfboard. Look at it, it's almost like a surfboard. It's pretty long. Way over there. Right there. Like a surfboard. Do what on purpose? Yeah, because they slow down here, I think. This guy goes really high. Going down again. Yeah, because you wanted to stay here for a while. That's the wrong way to lose weight.
The right way? We have the right way.
That's the right way to lose years off your life. What'd you say, Amanda?
It didn't look like this when we came
here. There was nobody here when we came here last time.
Where's who?
A guy with a broken arm.
Hey, broken arm.
No,
one arm guy.
Thank you. presentation of the ceremony. Please may we now stop the flash cameras and we'll stage photos afterwards for all of you to keep watching. And since that was a trial, did everybody hear? What is love? The spirit of love escapes our ability with words, doesn't it? In 1 Corinthians, we find the words, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Love is wanting to grow old together. Love is what has gathered us together this evening. Bill and Joni's love for each other and for us brought us the invitation, the witness of the blessed, the special ceremony tonight. It is our love to them that brought us together. Feel the love around you. Phil and Jonie, the relationship between you must keep growing, caring, changing, developing, forming a constant adventure. It will not be without conflict, but if you will face the differences openly, the possibility of learning how to convert problems into opportunities will not be lost, and your marriage will prosper. The celebration of love is the outward sign of the sacred and inward commitment. Religious societies may consecrate it. States may legalize it, but neither can create it, nor annul it. Such union can only be created by your loving purpose, be maintained by your abiding will, and be renewed by your human feelings and intentions. Phil and Jonie, are you now willing to bind yourselves to one another for better or for worse in sickness and in health? Who gives this woman unto this man?
My sisters and I.
Whenever I hold these shoes, I
Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Heavenly Father, which art in heaven, thy kingdom come. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Please be seated. In Ephesians, we find the marriage relationship defined. Wives, be subject to your husbands, as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. As the church is subject to Christ, so let wives be subject in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. Some of you might question the application of those words in the 20th century. Do not be among them. Let us look to see what Christ did for the church, and you will see that these words still apply. In John chapter 20, we read that St. Thomas wanted proof that Jesus had been raised from the dead. Jesus did not get mad because he was questioned. Instead, he had Thomas put his finger into his wounds. When Jesus came across the sick, he did not scorn them. He healed them. Jesus died for his church. Just from these examples, there are so many more. We see that there cannot be room for physical or mental abuse in a marriage. What we learn is that there must be an extraordinary amount of patience, of healing, and dedication. We invite the married couples in the audience to hold each other's hands, to renew their own wedding vows as Phil and Jonie exchange theirs. Face each other. Do you, Phil, now take Jonie to be the wife of your days, to love and to cherish, to honor and to comfort, in sorrow or in joy, in hardship or in ease, to have and to hold from this day forth? Do you, Jonie, now take Phil to be the husband of your days, to love and to cherish, to honor and to comfort, in sorrow or in joy, in hardship or in ease, to have and to hold from this day forth? May I have the This ring is in the form of a perfect circle of precious metal. The circle is a symbol of completeness and an emblem of eternity. The precious metal is that which has been tested and proved true. It is a fitting emblem of your love for each other and of your faith in each other. In the test of time, like gold in the fire, may your love and faith prove true and endure all your days. Please, everyone, join me in a prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask that you will renew your blessings upon Phil and Jonie. Bless their love and bless this ring. Let it be a constant reminder of their obligations in marriage, and bless this marriage and hold them in the hands of your love forever. Amen. Phil, take this ring and put it upon Joni's left hand while repeating after me. With this ring, I thee wed. Friends and loved ones, join with me now in acknowledging Phil and Jonie as man and wife. Phil, you may now kiss your bride.
not sure you did it right. It was great. Should bring. And may life grant you patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you always need one another, not so much to fill your loneliness as to help you to know yourselves. A mountain needs a valley to be complete. The valley does not make the mountain less, but more. And the valley is more a valley because it has a mountain towering over it. May you succeed in all of the important ways with one another and not fail in the little graces. May you look for things to praise and often say, I love you. May you have happiness and may you find it making one another happy. May you find love. And may you find it in loving one another.
So there are didn't have a plastic cabinet. We didn't bring the plastic cabinet.
Something else there to get that.
Thank you.
You're all in trouble for eating.
Well, we're not supposed to eat before the first group, but then you know. Didn't your mother teach you to eat manners?
Thank you.
you're in the camera right now. Your face is in the camera.
Go ahead and sit down, please, okay?
Thank you. indicator.
That's okay.
I hear good things.
I'm still talking to my boy. I'm like,
But
I will. Hi, Phil. Have fun on your honeymoon, and hope everything works out perfectly.
Thank you.
Jesse Gibbons here.
Yeah. Thank you.
wasn't a wedding ceremony.
Yeah, doesn't he? Doesn't he look familiar? He looks like this guy out here.
What do you use Prodigy for? Drone Prodigy?
Huh?
Drone Prodigy?
Yeah.
What do you go on there for? Special or just?
It's what we got with our computer.
Oh. We'll send you an email.
Real quick. We got the Prodigy Packard Bell. It's a 486, 4 megabytes. I know it's lame.
Hey, you know, we're on the web.
You're on the web?
Laura.Sanderson @west.sun.com. No, you know what everybody says now?
But
Sandra Bullock. No, everybody says I look like Sandra Bullock.
Sorry, Sandra Bullock's cute. Anyways.
Whoa! How did that happen?
Oh my god.
I got a Sportster 14.4 modem.
And he goes right on
an external modem, but I got a 2400 modem internal. Do I have to turn off the internal modem to make
you
the external modem work?
Should somehow remove it. Be best.
Yeah.
It might get confused.
Because I think that's what's happening.
Is this gonna be something?
Can you put your shoes in?
Yes!
You're gonna die too.
Woo!